everyone, welcome back to my channel. Thank you for tuning in. Coach Glory here from Glorious Glow Empowerment. I appreciate you all. Thanks for coming around every time I upload a new video. And if you are a new subscriber, I'd like to say thank you for subscribing to my YouTube channel. I appreciate you as well. Old subscribers, thank you for coming back. And if you haven't subscribed and you are listening, please consider subscribing and joining this family. Okay, so I would like you to do the following, please. Watch to the end. Thank you. I'd appreciate that. Subscribe, like I said earlier, if you haven't subscribed already. Like the video. Okay, and please leave a comment so I know you have listened to this video. And lastly, click on the notification bell. There's a bell right there. Click on it. That way you will always be notified when I upload a new video. You don't want to miss it because I have a lot of interesting topics I'll be posting onto YouTube. Well, today's topic, we're going to be looking at 10 positive steps to prevent loneliness in marriage. Today, I'm only speaking. You can't see me today. Okay, I'm only going to be speaking, and I hope you enjoy listening. Thank you once again. So, 10 positive steps to prevent loneliness in marriage. Okay, there are different reasons why people are lonely in marriage. Okay, it may sound weird. Why would anyone be lonely in a marriage? Right? Surprisingly, this happens. And there are various reasons. We're going to be looking at them one by one and looking at solutions as well. It may be as a result of mental health issues, lack of communication between the partners, or unresolved relational issues. Okay, unresolved issues in the relationship. Right now, I'm working with a couple. What happens in this marriage? Loneliness has set in. I will be giving examples, but I won't be using names, obviously, for obvious reasons. Loneliness has set in to the extent that they are both in the same house, but you can hear a pin drop because everybody is in different parts of the house. The woman may be reading a book, the man is on his laptop, watching a movie, or on his phone, or chatting with friends outside the home, while the wife is somewhere else in a different part of the house doing her own thing. That is not right. People in the same home not communicating. Obviously, issues will arise from that because the needs are not being met. That is not a good thing in a marriage. Marriage is meant for, or any kind of partnership is meant for, companionship. You are meant to be companions. Yes, there are times you want to do your own thing, but then let your partner know, okay, honey, I'm going to, you know, do whatever for a few minutes. There's that understanding. But when everyone gets up silently, no communication, just go out to do their own stuff, you know, nobody knows what the other person is doing, everyone has their own agenda, that is not ideal. That's not an ideal situation at all. And partners, couples should find a way to resolve this before it gets too far. Okay, so how do you combat these issues? The main thing is effective communication. Talk to your partner. Not just talking and say, oh, how are you today? No, talk to them on a deeper level. Get to the root of the situation. What is happening? Why are you so distant? Okay, let them express themselves. Okay, don't barge in and say, and try to defend yourself or something like that. And you want to be, you know, like, you know, who are you to tell me this or tell me that? No, that's going to make things worse. Listen to your partner. Communicate with your partner on a deeper level. Okay, talk from the heart. This is a time to really talk about things, deep things with your partner. You know, share your dreams, share your passions, with your partner, you know, make plans together as a family. These are ways to make sure there's never loneliness in your home. Make plans together. Have short-term goals, mid-term goals, long-term goals. Have these goals together. That makes everyone happy. That means you're both on the same page. And if you have children, they are watching you. They are seeing how mom and dad behave and, you know, do things in the house. And they will emulate that same thing in their own homes, you know. So as parents, it's important to show good examples, because children learn by observing, not by what you say. They learn by watching what you do. So as parents, it's important for us to be mindful of these things, all right? Now, sometimes because of this loneliness, people throw themselves into things like the effects. What are the effects of loneliness? The partners, each person becomes a workaholic. They throw themselves into their work, and they're always working because they know that if they're not working and they are beside their partner, nothing fruitful is coming out of it. There's nothing happening. You know, and it even gets worse because they are sitting beside someone who is not even present. The person may be on their phone, engaged with whatever it is they are doing on their phone, without recognizing, acknowledging that their spouse is sitting beside them or in the same room with them. So that loneliness deepens. And many people feel, well, instead of having that, I might as well throw myself into my work. You know, that's not good. This needs to be recognized and stopped. So some other people deal with loneliness in a different way. They begin to fantasize about their ex. You know, oh, I had it, you know, oh, when I was with this person or with that person. And before you know it, an affair results, because the needs are not being met at home. It's not a good reason. No one is saying that's good, but these things happen. Okay, these things happen. That's just the reality of life. And what I do on my YouTube channel is to bring us the facts, things that happen, in order for us to learn from them and make sure we combat it and it doesn't happen in our homes. Okay, yes, excessive drinking. Some people become drinkers because they're trying to numb the pain. Or some even go to the extent of substance misuse. You know, they start to misuse substance because they feel there's no way out. You know, they feel they've been held right to the corner and there's no way out. They feel there's no way to even leave that space, that spot where they are. They feel trapped. And the only way, or the only thing that comes to mind, is to misuse substances, because they feel all alone, like there's no one else to talk to. I'm here to say you are not alone. There is someone you can talk to. There is always someone you can reach out to. And if you feel there's no one you can talk to, or you don't want to talk to anyone that knows you, as you watch or listen to this YouTube video, contact me. I'm a coach. I'm here to listen to you and help you get out of that situation. You are never on your own. Okay? Loneliness can also lead to stress. And this results in so many things. You know, it also leads to depression, you know, poor diet. You stop taking care of yourself and all of that because of loneliness. This is a massive issue, and it's important to recognize it as soon as possible and deal with it. Now, what are the solutions? We have looked at effects and things that may cause loneliness in a marriage and all of that. Now, let's look at solutions to this. Okay. Now, I'm going to give 10 solutions. The first one is communication, which is the biggest one, effective communication. Talk about your feelings. How are you feeling? What has triggered this feeling? What did your partner do? Or what did your partner not do? What are your expectations? And how are they not being met in this relationship? Because your partner may be unaware. They may not know that this is happening. You know, they may be oblivious to the fact that whatever they may have done or may not have done has affected you in this way. So never make assumptions because your partner is not in your mind, doesn't really know what you're thinking, how you're feeling. So express yourself. And if you are the partner listening, you are the partner being spoken to, listen. It's not the time to say, I can't believe you are feeling this way. What? And then you bring all sorts into the talk and all that and make the other person even feel worse. No, that's not good. If you're the person being spoken to, listen. And once you have listened, express yourself as well. Apologize if you need to. Tell them you are sorry that you didn't know that they were being affected this way and you had no idea that your behavior or your actions caused this. And once you have apologized, it's not enough to now repeat it the next day. You know, say you have apologized and that's it. And then you feel you can go on and do whatever. No. Apologize and mean it from the heart. Okay. And become intentional. Okay. Be mindful of your partner's feelings. Be intentional. Look out for each other and say, okay, my partner has told me this. I will make sure I don't do it or minimize it. You know, talk to your partner. Become one. And then two, while you are listening, the second one, ask your partner deep questions about how they are really feeling. You may not wait for your partner to come to you. Your partner may be the reserved type who doesn't really express themselves and all of that. And you see that something has changed. Oh, there's something different about this person. Ask them questions. Don't wait for them to come to you. You go over, be proactive and say, honey, I mean, what's going on? You know, they may say, if it's the woman, she may say nothing. Trust me, when a woman says nothing, there is a lot going on. So don't just say, well, I've done my bit. I've asked her, you know, and she says nothing. And then you go about doing your own thing. No. Find a different way, you know. Maybe you asked her during the day and she said nothing. You asked her again, she said nothing, and you left her. And she's still not her usual cheerful self. Bring it up again at bedtime, you know. Go over to her, maybe wrap your hands around her and just say, you know, I've noticed some things. I'm not really happy that you are looking this way or something, you know. Trust me, that will soften her heart and she will begin to express herself and say, well, this and that. Ask deep questions, not in an accusatory way. You know, find ways to talk softly and bring things out and just have, you know, nice pillow talk and just really resolve issues. Okay? That goes a long way. And then by the time you wake up the next day, you know, the atmosphere has changed. The energy around the house is more positive. You don't want that toxic atmosphere around you. That's not good for you. It's not good for your partner. And it's not good for the children you are bringing up. Okay? Now, the third point, don't spend time on your device. That is a major one. In homes these days, devices. Everyone is on social media. On their phones, on their tablets, iPads, you know, laptops, computers, it is everywhere. And people are chatting more with people in a different part of the world than with their spouses or their partners. They have somebody sitting right beside them. They're not talking to that person. Instead, they are chatting, laughing, and all of that with somebody else in a different part of the world. And, oh dear, how do you think that will make your partner feel? The loneliness will just deepen because they will feel unappreciated and all of that, that, wow, you are laughing and spending all this time with your friends, or you don't even have time for them. So, have a rule in your home. Don't take your devices into your beds. Okay, have a rule. Okay, at this time, I'm going to do away with my phone, or if my spouse or is around me, make sure I'm not chatting with anyone on my phone. Those phones are, they are good. We have great use for our devices, but relationship matters. Let's take care of our relationships. Don't spend all your time on your phone or even TV. You're spending too much time watching the TV, ignoring the person in the room, same room with you, and all of that. You're not even minding. Even if you are watching a program, you may want to watch something together. While you are watching a program, you are sitting on the same couch, holding, just being emotionally present, being mindful of your partner, hold them, touch them. Let them know that yes, you are together. You can, just watch TV together in a nice way. And even if you're not talking, you are present together. There's that way of knowing that yes, this person is with me and all of that. But when you are miles apart, you're in the same room, but one person is on that end, the other person is on the other end, and that's not good. That's not good in the relationship. So we need to find ways to stop that. All right. Now, the fourth point is self-care. Now, if you are feeling lonely, examine your own self-care. How are you caring for yourself? Do you have your own activities? Let's not put too much weight and expectation on other people. Find things to keep yourself busy as well. Do you go to work? If you're not working and you're at home, do you have moments, when you just have downtime for yourself, relax, do things you enjoy as well, so you don't always look up to your partner to make you happy and all of that. So examine your own self-care. If you feel like your self-care is not good enough, look for things that you enjoy doing and start to do them. Examine your own self-care, because at the end of the day, you come first. Put yourself first. Your self-care comes first. Love yourself. Believe in yourself. Then you can pour out and appreciate the person, the other person, your partner. Because if you lack self-care and loneliness comes in, you begin to believe that you're not good enough and all of that. So if, no matter what the other person does, you may not be, he or she may not lift you up because you don't believe in yourself already. And so it would be unfair to put all that weight on your partner. Also, the fifth one in marriages, avoid the I. Okay, you're always I. You want to do things yourself? No. Instead, bring in the we. Okay, do things together. We. Think about the we, not the I. That would help you eliminate loneliness a lot in the relationship. The sixth point is to avoid the blame game. That's a big one, isn't it? Stop blaming the other person, okay? Or you blame yourself. If it's either you are blaming someone or you are blaming yourself, and then feeling guilty, wondering, why am I feeling this way? Why do I feel so lonely and all of that? Or you start thinking about different things about why you are feeling this way, and then you are beating yourself down all the time and things like that. That's not good. It's only going to make things worse. So it's best to avoid that at by all means, at all costs, to avoid that. That would help you overcome that feeling as well. Okay. Number seven. Yes, loneliness is a feeling. It is time to acknowledge it for what it is. It's only a feeling that will eventually ease off. Don't dwell too much on it. Okay? It is not a fact. It's only a feeling. If you can have that in your mind that, well, I'm feeling lonely, imagine that word feeling. I am feeling lonely. It is only a feeling. All right. But it's not a fact. So if you are able to acknowledge that and recognize it for what it is, it will ease off eventually. Okay, it's just the brain's way of, you know, when you dwell so much on something, it becomes exaggerated and it overshadows the positive things around you. But when you try, when you make it small and don't give it too much focus, it becomes smaller. Okay, you don't dwell so much on it anymore. And you tell yourself, this is not a fact. This is not who I am. It's only a feeling that will pass soon. Okay. Now, number 8, reach out to a trusted friend or a mentor. I believe in couples having a mentor. It's very important. So if you feel this has gone on for so long and you've done everything in your power, you've done everything you can and it still lingers on, reach out to someone. Somebody you trust, all right? You can't take this to everyone. Somebody you trust, or reach out to a mentor. Or reach out to a coach if you have one. Or if you don't have one, I'm a coach. Reach out to me. I'm here to help you. Number 9, recognize self-defeating thoughts. And then replace them with the truth. Okay, so these thoughts come to you. And like I said earlier, it's not a fact. So what can you replace them with? We have the I am statements. Most of us must have heard about this before now. So instead of believing the negative things and acknowledging those negative feelings, think about positive ones. I am good enough. I am beautiful. I am happy. Think about the I am statements. What can you put in front of that I am? And believe it. Believe it with all your heart. Okay? Whatever it is you want to replace those negative thoughts with, put them in front of the I am. Okay? And believe them as your truth. Before you know it, the loneliness begins to ease off. Lastly, pray about it together. Once you've communicated, and they've heard you, they have listened, you have also listened to them, pray together and show compassion to one another. Be kind to one another. You know, oftentimes people feel that once you get married, oh, that's it. You are always going to be happy. You're always going to be on top of the moon and all of this. No, that's life, reality. That's different in real life. Okay. So many people, everyone experiences this at one point or the other. So if you are single out there and you are still dreaming and all of that, this shouldn't come to you as a shock. This happens sometimes. It's not a time to now feel down and feel like it's the end of the world. This happens many times, all right? So as I've said earlier, the best thing is to go through. There are so many more points, but I've only listed 10, only a few. There are so many other things that can be done as well. Okay. Marriage is a place where people never think that loneliness can ever happen, but it does. All right. I'm not trying to bust your bubble. It does. The key is to be united. Okay. Be united. Help each other overcome the various challenges. Even apart from loneliness, there are other challenges that will come in a marriage. Help each other. Adopt the we, not the I. And never condemn or criticize each other. That will help you go a long way in overcoming loneliness or any other challenge that may come your way in your marriage. Thank you once again. I do hope you have enjoyed this and you go ahead and practice these tips I have shared today. That would really help. Let me know if this helps you in any way. Like I said earlier, I will be posting different topics about marriage, you know, about relationships. I am a family and relationships coach. I'll be posting topics regularly on my YouTube channel. I also post on my podcast. I have a podcast as well. You can follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook. I'm on Instagram. I'm on Twitter. Type Glorious Glow Empowerment and I will come up on different places on the internet, different social media. Yes, thanks once again. And I do hope you have enjoyed listening to me. And I look forward to coming again with a new topic next time. Do subscribe, leave a comment for me, press the like button and the notification bell. Thanks once again. Take care. Bye.